Due to the graphic nature of this program, content recommendation is for 18 and older. Listener discretion is advised.
Can you fly this plane and land it?
Surely you can be serious.
I am serious.
And don't call me Shirley.
All right, you paranormal lovers, it's time to talk about ghosts, UFOs, and everything in between with Wisconsin's very own paranormal shock, broadcasting live from coast to coast and worldwide, please welcome your friends and mine, the Beyond Normal Radio.
They sound so excited. They're like, all right. What is going on out there in Radio Paranormal Land? I am one of the hosts, Chris. Great to meet you. My co-host is Courtney.
Hi.
Hello. I'm excited for Chinese food, just saying. I'm getting a little hungry here. So, we are from the Westosha Paranormal Society, located in southeast Wisconsin, and this is the Beyond Normal Radio Show. That is right, we are a paranormal podcast, and have been around the airwaves since the year 2010, going strong for well over a decade. I've been a paranormal investigator since, I'd say, almost 24 years now. I'm really, really into, like, doing EVPs. That's probably one of my favorite things when it comes to doing investigations. I've been really good at doing, like, all, like, the audio and re-listening to everything that comes in. So it's been a good time, good long time. So this show is going to be great. Courtney, my co-host, she's also been into the paranormal for how many years now?
Well, excluding childhood experiences, I'd say the last 6 years.
6 years? Okay. Yeah, I mean, it's really interesting to say that the paranormal, the things that are just odd, you know, strange and unusual occurrences. And what I love about our organization, the Westosha Paranormal Society, is that, you know, we go out and we investigate the claims of somebody having some kind of paranormal activity. And our job is to go out there and see what's going on. You know, could it be just something faulty electrical box and it's giving off these crazy readings of EMF, you know, which has been known to show audio and visual hallucinations? Or it could be their dead grandfather that passed away 6 months ago. Or it's, you know, Sally Joe Robinson, who was murdered in this old house of theirs that's, you know, 200 years old, and they had seances and stuff like that. So there's all sorts of different cool things. But with this show, I'm just going to briefly talk about some stuff. Looking forward, we have everything from Bigfoot stories, alien encounters, paranormal teams of the week, playing EVPs, ghost stories, just pretty much everything under the umbrella of paranormal, and including Courtney's corner over here. She has some really good topics when it comes to, like, crystals, stones, rocks, all that kind of stuff. She'll also be doing, like, tarot readings, tarot cards of the week, you know, where we pick one and stuff and kind of explain what it means. So it's more on, like, the spiritual side of things as well. But yeah, this is going to be really fun. I'm really excited. This is episode 101 of the Beyond Normal Radio Show. And tonight, we are going to be talking about aliens in the United States and across around the globe for all you flat earthers out there. And don't give me that look. That's their slogan. We have members all around the earth.
It's not
around. Yeah, Google it. The Flat Earth Society literally says that We have members from all over.
Case in point, the globe. Case in point.
And I'm like, you know, okay, you know, maybe your spokesperson should rewrite that slogan, you know, because it's flat earth. But we'll talk about all that fun stuff, too, and, you know, space and inner dimensions and how the moon is just a hologram, or is it, you know... The blue sky that we see is the ocean, and our ocean's an ocean, and there's civilizations that live underneath. We dive into some crazy, wild shit. So this is going to be really fun, all right? You guys are in for a great, great time. So, recently, what's the big thing that we saw on from the internet, but, you know, newscasts and our government? What's been going on?
Well, they're talking about the whistleblower bringing to light the government cover-up of alien spacecraft and extraterrestrial pilot bodies that have been recovered and covered up by the government.
Which blows my mind, because we sat here and you know, we watched these clips when we put all this together for the show. And not only do we have exclusive content from the U.S. Congress here, but we also got exclusive content sent to us to the show of an actual alien recording of an alleged alien housed in a Colorado Air Force base underground. We're talking top secret shit, okay? So we have that for all you guys and gals out there listening to this wonderful show. So we're going to go ahead and jump into this, and I'm going to play for you a clip that we have from an interviewer interviewing somebody from the U.S. government. And they do talk about bodies, non-humans, craft, all that kind of stuff. This is really cool. So, check it out.
You say that the government is in possession of potentially non-human spacecraft. Based on your experience and extensive conversations with experts, do you believe our government has made contact with intelligence extraterrestrials?
Something I can't discuss.
If you believe we have crashed, do we have the bodies of the pilots?
As I've stated publicly already, biologics came from some recoveries.
Were they, I guess, human or non-human biologics? Non-human, that was the assessment people would recommend. And was this documentary, videos, photos, eyewitness, like how would that be determined? The specific documentation I would have to talk to you about.
It just blows my mind. It's crazy. It really, really is. Hey, so what did the mother ghost tell her little ghost?
I'm not sure.
Don't spook until you are spoken to.
Classic parenting advice.
Yes. What does a little ghost call his mother and father?
Couldn't say.
You could tell this was written in the 80s. Ooh, dinner's done. His trans parents. Oh,
certainly.
Yes. This is 2023.
You don't have any alien jokes. Keep us on topic.
I know. These are from like 1976. 101 ghost jokes. That is right. You guys are in for a treat. We're going to be talking about all sorts of fun ghost stuff.
We're going to bring Colton on as a guest.
Yes.
For jokes.
That's right. Dad jokes. That young man of yours.
Crocs and socks.
Yes.
And dad jokes.
You know, Caden, my son, you know, he actually gave me a dad joke the other day. I don't remember it because you know how well my memory is. But it was funny. And he was like, he did like the high five thing as I'm like laughing hysterically. And he's like, don't leave me hanging.
Then he put his sandals on over his socks.
Yeah.
Headed out.
I'm like, Jesus. So we're going to play this exclusive content here real quick, and then we're going to circle back like Jin Saki and talk about everything going on before we end our little podcast for the evening. So this is the alleged audio recording from an alien or alias of alien named Victor.
Game over, man.
Game over.
What the fuck are we going to do now?
What
are
we
going to
do?
We better get that because
I can hear this. If you're hearing this, my name is Victor. I only got a little time, but they want me to say this message. I am indeed one of these aliens, as you call it. Beings that they captured. I am down in the hill, but hey, okay, I'll say it. They do indeed treat you like they're friendly. I mean, I'm not too far into probing things, that's my thing, but I get it. We also get Popeyes every Tuesday, so that's always a good time. But anyway, they are very nice.
Hi, Mom! Hi, Jay! No, stop!
That is very interesting. That really is. I'm not sure what to take on that. I mean, it was a classified audio sent to us. We've gotten things over the years, you know, and it's just, it's interesting. I'm not sure what to take on that. But, Victor, if you are listening, that'd be amazing to, you know, give us a call or something. If you hear us. You know, if you're out there and you hear us, send us an email.
Popeyes.
Yes, that is right. I don't even remember what is our email. Oh no, it's not even up. I'm trying. I don't remember. You can contact us. Our email. Send us a ghost story, anything you would like, at WisconsinParanormalNetwork@gmail.com. That is our new network email here at the radio show, WisconsinParanormalNetwork@gmail.com. Send us something, anything you want. That would be really cool. And I don't know, we got about less than 2 minutes here. So my take on all this is that it's funny to me because people are, they're like, oh, the government's releasing alien information and this and that and whatever. And nobody is fazed by it. Literally, everybody's just like, cool. Like, I don't give a shit. You know, is it because we are desensitized? You know?
I don't know why they're still trying to cover things up when I think most of the population freely believes. Yeah. That's why we're not surprised.
Well, just like the Chinese spy balloon. Like, after that went down, we had all these different unidentified objects. I believe they even called them UAPs. Originally, they were UAPs.
Unidentified aerial phenomenon.
Right.
The new UFO phenomena.
You know, it's just, it's crazy. So, I think we're desensitized. I don't think people really give a shit because there's so much going on in our society, from high bills, gas, you know, food prices, everything. Nobody cares anymore. They're just like, cool, whatever. Maybe if a big mothership comes, might be a different story, you know.
Maybe.
But with that being said, it is time for us to leave for the evening. We have beautiful Chinese upstairs. So without further ado, you guys have a wonderful evening. We will catch you on the flip side. Have a good night.